April, last Tuesday and Wednesday, 9 people were killed in Nyanga Township. On the week of the 10th to the 16th of April this year, at least 6 bodies were found in Nyanga Township killed. Nyanga Township is known as the capital of murders in South Africa. In the 2014-15 financial year, 300 people were killed in Nyanga Township. And in the 2015-2016 financial year that ended last month in March, 280 dead bodies were collected in Nyanga. In all 3 police stations in Khayelitsha combined, 325 people were killed in the 2014-2015 financial year. On Wednesday, the 27th of April, the country will mark and celebrate 22 years of freedom. On the same date, the Community Police Forum and residents of Nyanga Township will occupy the Nyanga Police Station as a protest for shortage of police resources. In 2014, the Oregon Pikoli Khayelitsha Commission of Inquiry that investigated the breakdown of relations between the community of Khayelitsha and police found that, I quote, residents of the poorest areas of Cape Town that bore the brand of apartheid are still woefully under-policed 20 years into our new democracy, and often the police station with the highest levels of serious conduct crimes. This party needs to change as a matter of urgency, close quote. 2 years later, after the Khayelitsha Commission, this has not changed. 20 years later, after the TRC, the black working class is still subjected to poor services. On the 30th of March this year, the Social Justice Coalition and Equal Education launched a case against the Minister of Police in the Equality Court, challenging the unfair and racist allocation of police resources. The TRC was in a sad process. It was an opportunity for South Africa to face the demons of the past and heal. It was a platform for the oppressor and the oppressed to reconcile. It was an opportunity for the victims to forgive but never forget. 20 years after the TRC, have we reconciled? No, we have not reconciled. The dispossessed are still the dispossessed. The oppressed still live in similar conditions they lived under during the apartheid era. The TRC gave clarity on many cases, including the Kanimea Commission of Inquiry, the Sili Commission. The TRC also exposed the use of declassing to deal with traitors, the gross human rights violations, ineffectiveness of police, racial hatred, torture, detentions, and so forth. Black people who have been staying in PJS section in Khayelitsha since 1990 are still staying in shacks. They live in rats-infested informal settlements. There are no streetlights, there are no tar roads. The democracy they fought for has subjected them into inhuman conditions. The city of Cape Town provided porta-porta services for them to relieve themselves. A porta-porta is the same baggage system that was provided by the apartheid government. The only difference between the apartheid baggage system and the democratic baggage system is that the apartheid one was black, the democratic one is white. 20 years after the TRC, the people of PJS, of Winnie Mandela in Tembisa, Alexandra in Johannesburg, Danun as in New York and Port Elizabeth, are reconciling with their poverty. There is more talk of racism from individuals and not much as needed on institutional racism, like special inequalities, especially in Cape Town, allocation of police resources, and also there's little talk on the allocation of police resources when you compare black communities and white communities. In the 10 unsafest black areas in Cape Town, there is one police officer for every 1,043 residents. In the safest white suburbs, there is one police officer for every 173 residents. Early last week, Stats SA reported that, I quote, unemployment among those in the 15 to 35 age group increased from 34.2% in 2009 to 35.9% in 2014. Of the 5 million unemployed people in 2014, 3.4 million were young people, close quote. These unemployed people have a color, they are black. They are friends, sisters, brothers, cousins of the class of 2015 that demanded free education. education. There are sons, daughters, nephews, nieces of the 34 minors that were killed in Marikana on the 16th of August 2012. 20 years after the TRC, their moment is coming. One day we'll be forced to listen to their misfortunes. They have started communicating with us through violent service delivery protests. They continue to rob us in our townships. We have given them new names to hide our failures. We call them Amaparapara, Skolis, Okuluva, Thugs, Onwevu, and yet they represent the failures of the past 20 years of freedom and failed reconciliation project. 20 years after the TRC, blacks are still reconciling with their poverty. Their leaders have betrayed their hopes. The betrayers also betrayed the ideals they fought for and which they were also prepared to die for. Is there hope? Yes, there is hope. As South Africans, we must stand up and demand our rights. We must ensure that the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa is not only a celebrated document, but a living document. Thanks.
Thank you very much.